time, which was incredible. It's going to be hard, but we're going to just give it our all. Last time, we wasn't here as EMC, so I'm hoping that this makes it a little bit better. We do a little bit, some new records people haven't heard, and just let people know that the album's coming out and get them ready for it.
I'm Master Ace.
What up?
I'm Master Ace.
What up?
I'm Master Ace.
What up?
What up?
What up?
About identity, I mean, you set yourself as Wordsworth and Master Ace, and now it's EMC. I mean, how would you define, you know, EMC? What does it stand for?
Well, it's a collective crew of four solo artists that have a friendship. We've toured together, and the fans wanted something that the fans wanted. The fans made it happen. The fans were talking about it on the internet, and we decided that it was a good idea. Let's put our heads together and each contribute the same energy to the album and see how it comes out, and the album came out great.
So it was the fans that brought you guys together?
The fans gave us this idea to do the group thing. Fans, yeah.
Wordsworth!
What up?
I'm Wordsworth!
What up?
I'm Wordsworth!
What up?
What up?
What up?
The song, what it stands for, you hear it a lot. You hear it on the promos and on the videos and...
It's like it was something ASAP came up with, just right into the track. And I think, you know, I think everybody would probably agree. It's kind of, I think it's like the best intro as far as us, because people are asking and wondering all around the world what it stands for. This kind of gives them an opportunity to get different ideas and takes on what it stands for. And you know, Nicolay did the track. It's a beautiful thing, and it's like something that I think everybody around the world appreciate at one time, and also come up with their own meanings for what it stands for. You know what I'm saying? So it's generated a lot of success by the fact that everybody wants to know what it stands for. So I think that was a perfect single, the way to set it off.
We EMC!
What up?
We EMC!
What up?
We EMC!
What up?
What up?
What up?
We EMC!
What up?
We EMC!
What up?
We EMC!
What up?
What up?
What up?
So like solo artists coming together to form another group, how does this affect the way of, you know, making music, writing songs?
It's easier.
It's less easier. Rhymes to write.
Less rhymes to write.
It's less rhymes.
It's way less rhymes.
But I think also you have to, you know, we know Ace has been in it longer than him. We look at Ace for his leadership, putting it together, because you can't have too many chefs in the kitchen, you know what I'm saying? You can't have too many people with too many opinions. We all speak our mind, but at the same time, we try to come to an agreement that, you know, maybe majority rules over there was something we all agree with. Pretty much, you know, if Ace has an opinion on it, we all listen to that and probably respect that because he has more experience. You definitely have to ask somebody that you respect in the forefront, but also don't be afraid to say what you have on your mind.
Right.
I got a lot to say. My mom's usually my strong, stay locked away, but not today. I have to laugh on the real aftermath, kinda ill like I'm Dr. Dre. Sometimes I run to the club and get faded. This game makes you get shaded, I just hate it. But this song is a different kind of feeling. It's a new kind of feeling, it's a special kind of healing.
What?
And I can show what it is.
Okay,
best flow in the biz, you know what it is.
How does it work? Do you have like a couple of concepts and you say, guys, write some lyrics, or do you get together? I mean,
nah, like any one of us could come up with a concept for a record and we talk about it. Everybody says, yeah, I'm feeling that concept. And everybody goes to their neutral corners and get their pen and they start working on it. And then we don't really know what anybody has until they go in the booth and say the rhyme. And then, you know, I guess it's kind of my job to try to piece everything together, figure out the right order and what works first verse, second verse, and figure out the hook. And then if changes need to be made, guys go back and change the verses around or whatever. But that's really it. You know, we discuss the concepts among each other. But first we discuss the beats. Is everybody feeling this beat? Everybody likes that beat, then we're gonna go with that beat. If two guys like it, two guys don't, then we might say, oh, let's not do that beat. We just try to agree on all the beats, then we agree on the concept, and then everybody writes their verses, and then we might collaborate on the hook, and one person might come up with a hook, and that's pretty much how it went down.
Yeah, this is brand new Uptown, still in the box. It's the Yankees, 10-0, killing the Sox. This ain't hugging the block with a gat in your hand.
Uh-huh.
This is Boca Raton on a catamaran. With the sun beaming down, where you at in the sand?
What?
I feel like a lord and a cat with a plan.
Uh-huh.
This feels like a lord and a flash in the pan.
Yep.
This is milk in the cup, man. Catching your head.
Y'all fill us in
Sean Price on there. We got Little Brother on there. We got Ladybug's Echo on there. Producers, we got Ayatollah Frequency, Marco Polo, Kool-Aid, The R, J for Canada. We got Ninth Wonder. We got, it's like an all-star lineup of producers. You know, you gotta have the best beats with the best rhymes. So it's just what it is, the best beats with the best rhymes.
First in the class of me, my heart is a bottle of Jack, no glass of hit it. Now drink it up till I ain't nothing infinite. I'm reppin' it, pop can, that's a definite. Come on, these amazing rhymes, a song like this in these days and times.
The album really is like it's an international kind of thing.
We got
producers from
Netherlands, we got Croatia, we got Toronto, we got England.
Yeah, we got everywhere, man. Yeah, it's everywhere, man. It's, universal, man. Producers from everywhere, man. So that's why when we see y'all give us the CDs, we listen to them. The only way we got in touch with these people from them handing us CDs. You know what I'm saying? If we like it, we hear something, we might email you, might get a phone call. So, you know, give us the B-CDs.
Yo, I'm on the grind, still got my money on my mind, and I feel like I'm walking on the line.
Yeah,
when it seems like I'm running out of time,
what?
That's when I'm going on the grind. Hey, yo, I'm trying to make my dollars double. I don't found a place to fit in. The niggas trying to get into this power struggle. I work hard on the job like immigrants. Always trying to get my first half in advance. It sounds strange, but the rap game is not a game. You can make a lot of money, gain a lot of fame.
You said no more solo material.
Yeah, that's
Is that true.
That's true, no more solo albums. But that's okay because I have projects like EMC to keep me going, keep me writing. I'm doing an album with NOG that's supposed to come out next year. And I'm down to do like collaboration projects, you know, maybe with another producer. Maybe I'll talk DJ Premier into doing an album, me and him together. Some new gang star or something, I don't know. But I just want to do different things under different titles, under different, you know, names, just to mix it up. You know, I think the Master Ace album collection is complete. I'm happy with what I've done, what I put in, and I don't want to ruin it by doing some mediocre album later down the road. So I'll leave that where it is and put my energy into EMC, then the NOG project, and then who knows what after that.